Hello, we here. So you may be thinking, why is Jeb inside of a plane that is sideways in the middle of the ocean? So, long story short, it's testing a new SSTO. The SSTO can take off, at least that's good. It flew relatively okay during ascent, and it got to orbit with almost no delta V left. So I released the mission and flew the thing away. Great success. Very good. So, with the 35 meters a second that Jeb had, he made the maneuver node back to KSC and executed perfectly. But during entry, lost control. That's the thing, this experimental SSTO that was never flown before, and I activated fine control during entry, trying to do an S turn back to KSC. That's not good. So I lost control of the SSTO and regained back in the lower parts of the atmosphere, trying to land the thing, but it crashed into a million pieces. So now that you know the history, you know why Jeb stuck there. This is Jeb home, 270 kilometers south of KSC. So now that Jeb stuck, I need to rescue him with something. So I had three options. The first one was a boat, but boats are slow. The second option was a seaplane, but seaplanes are pretty limited. So I just thought with myself, why not use a VTOL? And that's what I did. So you can see right now in the screen all the tiny decisions that I was making while building this thing. In the end, I just used a 2.5 meter as the core section and used the 2.5 meter base as the VTOL engine base. So the first flight was not much of a flight because it didn't have enough air intake. So I went back to SP8, added more intakes with more air for this plane. Now that I added more intakes, the thing finally flew, but it was not aerodynamically stable. So back to SPH, literally. The third flight, we got to take off and fly the thing because I made some adjustments to the aero. So we had too much lift at the back, switched to smaller wings. But VTOLs are not easy to control, and that's what I learned the hard way. The fourth flight, we took off, and actually remember, so I guess SSTOs, you should go a little bit forward before activating your engines. And this flight was with two objects. First, how fast you can go to glide, and the answer is around 60 to 70 meters a second, so that's really good. And the second part of this flight was attempting a landing. So yeah, the landing was a landing, lost the Panther engine in the process, but the thing at least did a cool flip and landed in one piece. So I went back to SPH to add a couple new systems. One that was the oar system to be able to shift the mass a little bit forwards and back just to account for extra kerbals in the command module. I added the pontoon systems because this needs to land over water, so
back to testing.
I discovered that two is not enough. Yeah. Back to SPH, I add a third one to try to make this thing float a little bit better. And I add a ladder system to be able to get back to the craft because it's a little bit high over the water when it lands. Back to testing again. Now with the ladder system and the new pontoon system on the craft, land the thing, and Rubens go out into the water to test the new ladder system works. So back to the SPH to add the final system to rescue job. That's just a landing gear. So now that all the systems are in place, it's time to rescue job, and we replace Rubens by noob for the mission. Because if fails, I can't just blame him because he's a noob. So I time warp during day to be able to see where I'm going. This has lights, but during day it's better for recording this. So I mark where job is on the map view to be able to know exactly where I'm going using Waypoint Manager. That's such a useful mod. So if you want Waypoint Manager, most likely is the link is on the description. and takeoff. The takeoff happens without a hitch. That's surprising because I didn't test this beforehand, so I was expecting to lose at least the back end of the craft and go for it. But that's the thing, like, this craft is really slow. Like, if I made boat, the chances are the boat would be as fast as this. But that's what happens when you don't test 100% of your system, you just test the VTOL section. In the end, putting weaseling in the back would be the right solution. But at least it looks cool. During flight, I'm using the deploy function to adjust the pitch angle, and with that I can fly during time warp without sacrificing much control. Pro tip to you. And with that, we are really getting really close to Jeb. Now, as we get close to Jeb, we use about a third of our fuel reserves. I didn't add the fuel capacity in this flight with fears that would make like VTOL a little bit more problematic. The higher TW, the faster you can go back up again. So now we are just hovering over Jeb place and getting closer. But I'm not good at flying this thing, so I just slam a little bit too hard getting close by. Now we just adjust everything else and go into boat mode to get as close as we can to Jeb, making drift during the process, and Jeb goes to the water and use our thrust lead system to the craft. Good thing that I tested. The last thing that you want is to get to here after an hour of flight and just not be able to climb up. I activate all the VTOL engines again, use the R system to shift the mass a little bit back to adjust for the mass of Jeb. That's about 80 kilograms, a little bit more because it has jetpack and the parachute. And now we can fly again back to Cassie. But before that, we need to first target the place and do a little bit of a mental check to not crash this thing. So we throttle up and are able to lift off. Perfect liftoff, as expected, after testing this thing for so long. Delete the Jeb checkpoint because it's not necessary, and point towards KSC for a last time and activate the Panther engine. Now we have about 2/3 fuel to go back, which is more than enough because we still have about 1/3 of reserves when we get back. And now we have the board journey home with Jeb inside. Nothing much happens on this part because guess what? This is a plane, and planes don't cause much issues. As we get close, the giant marker above Cassie shows up, and we know that we are just a couple steps away from home. Take one last shot before coming back, and prepare to land back on top of the VAB. But if you watch the thumbnail, you know how this thing is going to end. Because, yeah, flying VTOLs, not the easiest thing to do. Even more with Weasleys. Weasleys have such a terrible jet lag. You throttle up, and it takes a few seconds for the engine to go back again. So, this is the final descent. We are only 500 meters off the sea level and try to go slowly backwards. But that's the thing with VTOLs. Any moment, you're always a few seconds from screw up. Fly over the target and just lose control. Yeah, flying VTOLs, not my forte. The gear bounces and everything crashes down. But hey, at least Jeb's back home. So if you like the video, consider subscribing. If you want to support the channel, there's the links on the description, plus the craft files used on this mission. Goodbye, until next time.